Hello class, we are going to discuss on four slides for this session. This is a continuation of the benign mesenchymal tumors. We have slide 210, that is schwannoma, slide 95, lipoma, slide 166, that's cardiac myxoma, and slide 144, this is hemangioma. Okay, so let's start with schwannoma, slide 210. So schwannoma is a benign tumor that originates or is derived from peripheral nerves. They are composed of Schwann cells and they would stain positive for S100. A mutation to a gene NF2 would be noted in schwannomas and would cause a loss of expression of Merlin, okay, which is its product. Histologically, what we would see would be two areas. This would be the hypercellular areas, noted to be dark area. And then we have the lighter areas, that would be the hypocellular areas. Okay, so hypercellular areas would be called Antoniae, A-N-T-O-N-I. Then A, hypocellular areas are what we call as Antoni B. So those are the important things. For Antoni A, what would be important is that you identify for the presence of the nuclear palisading of the that would be seen. It means that the nuclei would radiate to the same direction. Okay. Hypocellular areas, of course, you do not see the Schwann cells. Okay, so this again would be benign tumor. Next, we go to slide 95. Slide 95 is a benign tumor that's called lipoma. So if we are going to ask what would be the origin of this particular tumor, it would be from the fats or from adipose tissue. So it's very difficult to differentiate this one from the subcutaneous tissue. This is identified to be located at the subcutis of extremities or the trunk. So histologically, what we would see would be mature adipocytes. What would be the appearance of adipocytes? They have abundant clear cytoplasm and the nuclei would be located at the periphery. Okay? So this is lipoma. Next, we go to slide 166. This is cardiac myxoma. Okay, so this is from the heart. Okay, so I'm going to move the slide around so that you can get oriented with the parts of the slide. Okay, so we go back to that area. This one, this area, you just look. You just follow the pointer. This area would be part of the myocardium. Okay, so this would be composed of muscle, cardiac myocytes. Okay, and this area would now be that of the myxoma. Okay, there. So how do you know that it's already the myxoma? You look at the stroma, it shows something like a fibrin, but this is what we call as a myxoid stroma. So what would be the cells present? They are called myxoma cells. Okay, so myxoma cells, those are the ones that are stained pink. Okay, this would be the nuclei, this would be the nuclei. They can be round to spindle cells. Do not mistake or confuse them for these darker cells. These are what we call as hemosiderin-laden macrophages. So these are macrophages, they are not the myxoma cells. So myxoma cells, a myxoma would be a benign tumor. They are located at the chambers of the heart. Most common would be at the left atrium. So although they are benign, they may cause a ball valve mechanism that causes cardiac tamponade. Okay, so it causes a decrease in the cardiac output and may cause hypoperfusion. Okay, our last slide for today would be called hemangioma. So, hemangioma is slide 114. So, for purposes of orientation, this tissue would be coming from the liver. Okay? So, so you can remember, the liver would be composed of hepatocytes, and the spaces here would be sinusoids. Okay? So again, this would be part of the liver. But that is not what is important. I just want to give you the orientation. So what would be notable here would be the adjacent structures to the liver tissue. This would be composed of spaces that are filled with red blood cells. Okay, there. So these are spaces that are filled with red blood cells. This is part of hemangioma. So the hemangioma would be composed of blood vessels. It can be small, like capillary, or they can be large, like this one. This can be what we call as cavernous hemangioma if you would see large spaces like this one. And because these are blood vessels, they are lined by endothelial cells. Okay, so this would be the endothelial cells. If you remember histology, these are simple squamous cells. Okay, so again, hemangioma. So those are the four slides that we are going that we have discussed. So that would end our session with midterm. So stay safe and good night.